Go ahead.
Okay, so we're gonna mirror whatever leg he's forward, I'm stepping forward. When I collar tie, I'm reaching with my back arm to get the collar tie, I go inside bicep with the other hand. Now I'm gonna steer him, make him lower his level, steer him in this direction to bring this leg even closer to me and lower my own level. Now I have options between heel and knee as far as ankle pick or knee pick. I'm gonna look ankle pick first. When I drop my hand, I wanna take it all the way to the mat. It's a heel or a knee and not in between. Right? Now I don't try to send him straight back, I wanna steer him to the dead angle so his hip hits the mat. Immediately he sits up and he wants to start to go to a sitting guard. So I wedge my knee up the middle and I collar tie and I make sure my knee goes over the hip the same size as the collar tie. If the elbow's away from the body, I can do a rolling Kimura. I don't grab at the wrist, that telegraphs the move. Instead, I opt for past the elbow. It would appear as though you can get to my back, but you can't because I'm operating in a very small space and my back hits the mat first. I lock my feet before and I link. What I'm looking for is for him to start to reach and come towards me and use his forearm to fight out. When I see that, there's a gap between his elbow and his ribs. Very easy for me to take my leg, place it through, and I just lock a shallow triangle for now. Once I have that, I can keep the arm secure, my bottom arm with a half tombstone grip, elbow to chest. Now my top arm's free, I grab his forearm, and I pull it in. I want to make sure my bottom leg's not stuck under his back, and I want to make sure my top leg is dug in as far as I can get. So I set my legs far away, straight and far away. Now my top leg falls in, and I figure forward under my bottom leg, and I go back to my original Kimura grip, pulling his wrist in towards my hip, and slowly I cinch for the finish.